This is our second mission with UNHCR and our first time in Jordan. We went straight to Azraq camp. But I don't think anything had really prepared us for just how yeah. much of a moonscape it was.
We met with a Shadi. Maths teacher, Shadi, and his new bride.
And they had met in the camp.
Yeah, Sawa. And they'd actually just had a baby.
Baby Sham.
Yeah, so they were literally beginning a new life together. Yeah. He'd been doing his physics degree at university and that had been interrupted by crisis. And so he was working as an assistant relief teacher in the schooling system inside Azraq, teaching maths. So he was very adamant about, once again, about returning to Syria and about teaching a generation of youngsters to be able to go back and make a new society. Once again, it was all focused on he was all about the future. They both were.
And we got an impromptu maths lesson, which was astonishing. But, you know, he was incredibly resourceful and adaptable and positive. He was so alive with the magic of maths that he was wanting to show them positive tricks and give them an instant love of learning. And he was such an inspiring teacher. I thought, my God, if only I had had a maths teacher like Shadi, perhaps I would not be an actor.
No,
well, perhaps I still would be an actor. I mean,
but you'd be better at maths.
I'd be slightly better at maths. It was our trip. We met a Daffy scholar, Ala. She was 8 months pregnant. She'd been studying media and journalism in Syria, and she hoped through the Daffy scholarship that she might continue and complete that. But that wasn't on offer, so she was going to complete her tertiary education and become a teacher. But she said, as long as I can complete and get a certificate and a degree, she just wanted to move through to that last stage in her education. And she was 8 months pregnant, and she walked for 80 minutes a day, and then to get the bus for 10 minutes. And she said, and I'm very tired because she's 8 months pregnant. I know what that feels like. She was so determined to complete that she was going to make that, you know, that 80-minute walk through the camp and beyond to catch the bus. Whether one goes on to be a doctor or a lawyer or a teacher, it's about having the engagement in the world and the access to information. You know, it's that desire to connect is there, and I mean, and that's what makes us all human. We have a deep vein of compassion, and it's you know, it feels like as a species we're kind of at a fork at the road. Do we go down the compassionate path or do we go down the path of intolerance? And I know, as a mother, I want my children to go down the compassionate path. There's much more opportunity, there's much more optimism, and there is a solution down that path. There is no solution down the path of intolerance.